for all horror stories. Horror. 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 Horror.
When I was a really little kid, this local small amusement park that used to be opened by us would hold this annual event called Pumpkin Land, which was held on the Saturday before Halloween, where candies would be given out to kids in between rides, and pumpkins would be scattered throughout the park for families to pick up and take home before leaving.
Oh, wow.
I always looked forward to it. And this one particular year when
I was seven,
we were going right after my soccer game.
Oh, wow.
The park also rewarded kids for coming in costumes. So I was going in my cliche Scream costume.
Anyway, I just reacted to a video called Scream.
My brothers begged to go on the haunted coaster first, and then the roller coasters. Basically, they wanted to do the most thrilling rides first. Anyway,
for real, I mean, I would too. Cars for the haunted I've never ride. Done those before, though. Since they only never before. Before. Never. I hate those. Those I can never do.
I started to get cold feet, and I felt like I needed to use the bathroom. So we got off the line, and my dad led us to the bathroom.
Wow.
He went too, but I finished first. So I waited outside the bathroom. I waited for a while. I was kind of confused. Eventually, I went back to the bathroom, and my dad wasn't in there.
Oh, no.
That's when I started to panic. I was alone in a huge crowd of people.
His dad got kidnapped by the Illuminati.
I was scared of being lost.
Yo.
Eventually, a man came up to me and asked where my parents
were. His dad got kidnapped by the Illuminati. That's what happened.
He took my hand and said, "We're going to go find them."
Everyone knows when somebody goes missing, when you have a family member that goes missing, it's the government. It's the government who does it. We all know we're being watched by the government, and we all know we said something here and there. It's the government taking our family. It's definitely the government. I'm gonna be shocked. I'm gonna be so shocked if it's not the government. Hold up, this might be me. Oh my gosh, yo, I just saw the UP, the FedEx. What is that, FedEx guy? He just tripped. Oh, bro. What a fumble, bro. But is this me? Bro, they never knock. Bro, why don't they knock? I don't know when they don't knock when they drop off a door, bro. Gosh, I hope that's not me. But yeah, let's just get right back into it.
I remember him leading me with a tight grip of my hand, and suddenly he pulled out his archaic Nokia brick cell phone and started talking to someone on the other end.
Bro said Nokia, no brick, yo. Was, oh, 6 inches.
He looked down at me and
made out of fiberglass techware.
He looked at me again and said that was my dad, and that he was waiting by the parking lot. He continued to lead me, but even at 7 years old, I wasn't an idiot. I was wise to the fact that my dad did not have a cell phone, and that this stranger probably didn't know my dad. How would he even know who I was if I was under a Scream mask?
It's the government.
As we were approaching the front gates of the park,
like I
spotted a female employee and started saying,
like I said, it's the government. I'm telling y'all, bro. Y'all cannot escape the government, bro.
Excuse me over and over until
y'all
I got her attention. Then I said,
bro,
I don't know him. Please help. The man defended himself, saying he knew my dad and was trying to get me to him. But the employee took my side and asked me to come stand by her so she could use the loudspeaker to find my parents. The man didn't stay a second longer after that. He walked away quickly into the parking lot. The employee announced over the park intercoms that a child in a Scream costume was missing his parents and gave my name. Eventually, my dad came running over, waving his hands. He was a nervous wreck.
Mm-mm.
The employee told him of the potential predator and the possible attempted kidnapping, and that's when he lost it. When my mom came over, she was just as furious. My parents asked the manager to see the surveillance footage. Somehow, at that time, the amusement park didn't have any surveillance cameras, according to the manager.
Harold. So
my parents thanked that employee for
Harold's
away
up
from
there. The
we
real ones know, Harold. Harold,
I
over
was
there.
Too young to realize the severity of the potential situation I had just avoided. Obviously, remembering it as an adult is a lot more sickening to think about.
Alright, well, that was story one. That one, I didn't get that one. That one, I didn't think was scary at all. Did he even find his dad in the end? Bro, did he ever even find his dad? But I don't think he ever found his dad. I don't think he ever found his dad. He never found his dad. I don't think he ever found his dad.
Like, my mom and stepdad went on their honeymoon. I wasn't trusted to watch the house for the week, so they sent me to my Uncle Ronnie's farm. He lives with my Aunt Susan.
I always got left at the house.
They have a spare bedroom upstairs that I stayed in.
Always.
It's an old-fashioned style wooden farmhouse. It's big and nice, though. The spare bedroom overlooked the crops, and the numerous scarecrows my uncle had scattered through the crops.
Nice.
This was in mid-October a few years ago, and my uncle was mid-harvesting his corn at this time of the month. He asked for my and Junior's help. Weirdly, it wasn't tedious work. Like, I kind of enjoyed doing it. He wasn't using his combine. Instead, we were just hand-picking a bunch of corn. I had this little rolling basket-like thing that I was supposed to fill up. I admired the three scarecrows he had. They looked like he put a lot of work into them.
I'm sure he did.
They had sweatpants on and varying flannels, along with straw hats over their heads. When we were done picking the corn, I asked Uncle Ronnie how long it took to make those. He said a few hours at most, and he said they really do the trick keeping the crows away for the most part. That night after dinner, I played video games and smoked weed with Junior for a little bit. Then I just went to the guest room to do whatever on my laptop.
He was a bad kid, bruh. Don't be like that. Don't do that. That's bad, bruh. They push in this agenda telling kids to go out and do substances. I'm telling you right now, don't go out and do that, bruh. Yo, be smart, alright? Don't do that. Start a YouTube or something. Don't go out and do substances, bro. Bro, the last thing you want to be doing is doing substances. Let me tell you that, because you know what's going to happen? You're going to end up becoming broke because you're going to be wanting to just buy substances. And you're going to want to get... Like, bro, no one wants to, bro. You're going to lose all your friends, you're going to lose your family, you're going to lose everyone, alright? Trust me.
I just closed my laptop screen so there would be total darkness in the room. I crossed my fingers it wouldn't happen again, but when a second rock hit the window, my heart felt like it dropped out of an airplane.
And see, he's probably imagining all this. He's probably, like, tripping on acid or something.
The room was still completely dark, so I gave it a minute before getting up to peek out the window.
He's tripping on acid and he's...
One of the outside lights was on, both lighting up a decent amount of the crops.
Like, this stuff is happening?
I continued to look around, but when I saw something moving in the corner of my eye, I looked back at the scarecrow to see one of its arms waving at me. No.
I'm actually scared.
It's hallucinating.
No, this is just loud. It's just loud.
I shut the blind and wanted to throw up. I ran to Junior's room and opened the door, but by this
time,
he was already asleep.
Well,
I closed his door and checked downstairs for my aunt and uncle, but all the lights were off downstairs, so I checked their bedroom, and they too were both asleep. I went back to my room and lifted the blind just enough to peek out there. The light outside was now off, but with the bright moonlight, I was able to see the scarecrow was still hung up on the stick. I looked out that window for over a minute, waiting for it to move again. But the longer I waited, the more I realized I must have been higher than I realized. I finally dropped the blind back down and climbed into bed.
This is why you don't do substances.
Next morning, I went downstairs to my aunt's.
This is why.
Pancakes. My uncle was already outside.
This is why.
Aunt Susie called Junior down to eat before all the pancakes were gone. And around that same time,
this is why.
Went into the house asking, where did the goddamn scarecrows go? My heart dropped.
I told you. You should have watched. You should have went up to him.
That all three scarecrows
and lit him on fire. That's what you should have done.
What I saw last.
I would have went up to him and lit him on fire, bro.
It all made sense. The nightmare.
I would regrow my corn, bro. If it takes that, bro. I gotta regrow the corn, bro.
That night when we were all sleeping, the doorbell rang continuously at like 1 or 2 in the morning.
Nah, bruh. It's the scarecrows.
My uncle and Junior yelling in the hallway and running
downstairs. It's the scarecrows. Watch out.
When he opened the front door, the three scarecrows were posted up right.
How did I know, bro? That's actually crazy.
My uncle called the police and turned on all the outside lights on the property. The police, as well as my uncle, chalked it up to some stupid early Halloween prank by a bunch of immature kids. But the possibility that it wasn't, and that it may have been a much more hostile motive behind this, is what really freaked me out.
Bro, I would've lit on fire. Bro, you come back to my property? Bro, you first, I'm giving you a home, right? I create you, right? Because they created them. They created the scarecrows, alright? See, that's why I don't get... These aliens, okay, it's just like aliens creating the humans. And then the aliens don't want the humans anymore. So they go out and just try to destroy the aliens. But the aliens, you know, the humans run away. I don't know. What I know is, I would have lit them things on fire. Excuse me. I got the hiccups. Story 3.
It was November. All the leaves were varying shades of yellow and orange. My favorite
time. I would have lit my fire. Story 3.
I was with my girlfriend at her dad's upstate home, which was usually used as a summer home. But the two of us came up there to go camping in the nearby woods. The home had all the needed camping supplies, including the tent. So we parked there and took the camping stuff into the woods. Nice. Why? Just the experience of camping and sleeping in the woods, I guess.
I've only been camping a few times in my life. I want to go camping. My girlfriend's like,
and of course, you can't beat the foliage. We were camped out in a small circular clearing, just big enough for our tent and campfire. We sat around the fire for about an hour, eating and just talking. Then we went inside the tent. We kept the fire going as it made my girlfriend feel safer, and it added a bit of warmth.
Nice.
Besides the sound of the crackling fire, we eventually started hearing leaves crunching.
I like this story.
My girlfriend and I looked at each other. She put her finger up to her lip. I could tell she was nervous. Fires usually repel wildlife from approaching, so as the crunching of the leaves got louder, it got more suspicious. Footsteps also sounded bipedal, like a human's footsteps. The crunches got louder until they stopped around the fire. Then we noticed the shadow outline of someone standing out there, and then they sat down in one of the chairs, but they didn't say a word.
Oh no!
So I finally decided I was going to peek my head out and check. I looked out to the campfire, expecting to see someone sitting on one of the chairs, but there was no one out there.
Nah, bro, you just saw someone! Campsite,
into the trees and darkness. I didn't see anyone out there.
You just saw someone!
My girlfriend was whispering something. Bro. It sounded like she was urgently trying to get my attention. So I crawled back inside, and she said, "What does he want?" I replied, "There's no one there." She replied, "What are you talking about? I see him in the chair right now."
Right, bro. That's what I'm saying.
I saw the shadow outline of the person still sitting in the chair by the fire. I realized that was impossible, though. I crawled back out of the tent to look one more time, and both the chairs were still empty.
Are you being serious with me right now? I went back inside
and said to my girlfriend, "We need to go right now." She didn't ask questions. She got straight up, took my hand, and followed me out of the tent. When she saw there was no one sitting in the chair, she screamed. I yelled at her to shut up, and I led us through the near total darkness in the direction back to the mobile home. While running, we heard this horrible groaning sound not too far away from us, and one single loud crash of a tree branch or something. This caused both of us to scream, "Oh shit," and run even faster.
Oh my gosh!
How we found the
no way!
Repeatedly pressing the car lock button until we finally heard the car horn. We went into the mobile home, locked the door, and hid under the covers in the safety of the bedroom. Still, I didn't feel entirely safe being surrounded by nothing but woods in every direction.
Oh my gosh.
Whatever was out there followed us. I let my girlfriend sleep while I stayed up for sounds. I thought I heard a clicking or something from the front door to the home. But that might have been my parents.
Bro, these are so trash. This one's not bad.
I fell asleep eventually, and when we woke up, we went back for the tent and supplies, scared shitless while doing so. Nothing was moved except for the one chair we thought we saw the shadow sitting in. It was knocked over. We hurried back to the car, drove home, and that was our last camping adventure.
Well, that was honestly... It was mid. Middle button. But yeah, those were three true disturbing fall horror stories. I really liked that last one. It kind of got boring at the end, but who cares? It was alright. But I'm going to be linking this video in the description below if you guys want to go check it out for yourselves. Go check out my other scary story reactions I do in the description below. I think you guys will like them because every video tells a story. You know, happy fall. I love y'all, man. Go out and buy some fall stuff for your house and go decorate. Splurge, because the end of the world is coming. Make sure you subscribe so you can be free, and I'll see you guys in the next react. This has been Bear with the React. If it ain't a react to a bear, then it ain't a react at all. Screw.